The mob tried to kill him once. He survived. And ever after that was called Lucky. He became the godfather of the modern crime syndicate. Charles Lucky Luciano climbed the mob ladder. He organized organized crime. He became an equal opportunity mob boss. But his creation of a murder-for-hire ring made him one of the deadliest.
In the early 1930s, New York was a mob killing field. Out of this bloody chaos, there emerged one cold-hearted, brilliant gangster named Lucky Luciano.
You never looked in his eyes, because it was strange, it was haunting, weird.
Lucky connived and killed his way to the top. When he got there, he laid the foundation of modern organized crime, and the money poured in.
He loved being Charlie Lucky Luciano, the number one gangster in town.
Luciano thrived on his reputation as the biggest racketeer and the most eligible bachelor in Manhattan.
Every time he would walk into a room, I'd get like butterflies in my stomach. It was like a sexual attraction.
But Lucky paid the price for his notoriety when a crusading gangbuster named Thomas E. Dewey sent him off to prison. Behind bars, Lucky not only kept his position as chairman of the mob, but came to the aid of his beloved United States during World War II, greasing the way for U.S. troops invading his native Sicily. After the war, the gangster who loved America was forced to leave it behind. But Lucky would then prove that the mob, like other big businesses, was not troubled by national borders. Lucky could run a racket anywhere, and did. The man who would one day make the mob run like a big business was born in the poor Sicilian town of Lercara Fridi on November 24, 1897, and given the name Salvatore Lucania. It was a town where most of the men, including his father, worked long days in the sulfur mine at the top of the hill. A hard life from which the family longed to escape. Hearing that across the ocean, America had streets paved with gold, they sailed to the promised land in 1907. The family found a flat in a Jewish neighborhood on the Lower East Side of Manhattan, just a few blocks from relatives in Little Italy. Only the streets were not as promised. Housing was cramped and dirty. Crime was rampant. Young Salvatore, one of four children, enrolled at PS 40, but he rarely showed up at school. Soon, he was dumped into the Brooklyn Truant School. By age 14, he was a dropout. His first job, delivery boy for a hat maker, earned him $7 a week. Chump change to many of the young hoods that Charlie encountered on the streets. Their racket, shaking down immigrants who sold food and clothing from pushcarts. Salvatore also saw kids his own age, gambling, fencing stolen goods, and dealing drugs. The streets were soon his classroom of crime. He was an eager and clever student.
There was always a suspicion that he used that job of delivering hats when he first started fooling around with the sale of illegal drugs, and that he would put some in the hat boxes as a good hiding place and stroll along. There'd be nothing in his pockets incriminating. When he wanted to make a delivery, just reach into the hat box, make the sale, and continue on his way.
He heard the lure of the street at a very early age, at least by the age of 14. He, by then, had committed to a criminal life. He was out there doing small-time crimes, smoking opium, having a sex life of sorts.
New York City police caught up with him for the first time at the age of 18. The charge? Possession of heroin. By then, he was using various names, including Charles Lucky Luciano. But for the moment, his luck had run out. He got a year in prison. Luciano's hardworking parents, embarrassed by their drug-dealing son, never visited him in prison. After 6 months behind bars, Charlie was released, having used the time to further his criminal education. Besides peddling dope, he now gambled, earned much more money, carried a gun, and joined his first Italian gang, the Five Pointers. The gang was well-connected. Every election day, its job was to harass voters, sometimes at gunpoint, into supporting New York's corrupt Democratic machine known as Tammany Hall. For this, the gang was well compensated.
That would enable them to engage in their other criminal activities during the year with a very understanding Tammany Hall, who appointed the police captain in each precinct, who appointed the magistrate that you would be brought before if you should be arrested. So you got protection for all of your illegal activities during the course of the year if you worked for Tammany Hall on Election Day.
But Tammany Hall couldn't always protect the gang. In 1923, federal narcotics agents arrested Luciano for dealing heroin. Charlie decided to save himself by ratting on some Jewish gangsters who had a trunk full of heroin in a basement on the Lower East Side. It was nothing personal against Jewish crooks. In fact, Charlie, who had grown up in a Jewish neighborhood, was unique in his early willingness to work with gangsters of any background.
And if they could get along together and make money together, that was the only standard that Luciano had. He didn't care what your nationality was or what your